Okay guys, so I'm going to be doing the second video on the channel today. Today we're going to be focusing on supplementation and what actually works. Okay guys, so the first two supplements that we're going to be focusing on are going to be whey and casein protein. Okay, so both whey and casein are dairy-based products. Whey protein is a quick or fast-acting protein, so it's absorbed rapidly into your body. Casein, on the other hand, is a slow-releasing or slowly digestible protein. Both whey and casein contain multiple essential amino acids, and both whey and casein protein help to assist in the building of muscle, along with assisting in increasing in strength gains. Now, whey protein on its own, there have been a small amount of studies to suggest that it may hold the potential to reducing inflammation of internal organs. So again, as previously stated, whey protein is typically a fast-acting protein, so you're taking it in, you want to get a quick hit of protein that's readily available. Casein, on the other hand, is slow-releasing, so typically this one's taken in later at night. Now, why would you take it in later at night? Your body can enter a catabolic state late at night, so it can actually, in fact, end up breaking down your muscle. So by taking in casein late at night, it's slowly releasing throughout the entire night, so it's actually helping to prevent your body from eating away at your muscle. It's because of this that casein is in fact known as an anti-catabolic agent. Now when it comes down to recommendations for casein and whey, I'd say literally just follow the instructions that are on the sachet or on the large packet of protein that are just on the back. Okay guys, from here we're going to be talking about creatine. Now creatine is one of the most studied supplements and it has been found to be safe for consumption for pretty much everyone. So what is creatine? It's a naturally occurring substance within our body. The main purpose of creatine is to actually help to provide our body with energy. So how does creatine provide our body with energy? Creatine molecules actually carry phosphate molecules. Now, the purpose of them having these phosphate molecules is that once our body does some kind of an action, so something that requires energy to do, we use things called ATP or adenosine triphosphate. Now, when we use these molecules, they lose a phosphate molecule and become a low energy molecule known as ADP or adenosine diphosphate. Now, when these creatine molecules come along, they attach their phosphate molecule onto this ADP molecule, which in turn creates ATP again and allows us to create more energy for other movements. This is how creatine can in fact help you to get those extra few reps in or to maybe perform a sprint again a little bit quicker. Some of the potential benefits associated with creatine are increases in overall muscle mass along with increases in strength as well as explosive power. Now how do we take creatine? Typically you'll be recommended to take an initial loading phase for the first week of up to potentially 20 grams a day. From there you'll be entering your maintenance phase of creatine consumption where you'll be on roughly 3 to 5 grams a day. Now when it comes down to creatine you're looking to cycle it. So by cycle it I mean you could be taking it for 8 weeks straight followed by 8 weeks of not taking it. It could go a little bit further than that, you could go 12 weeks and 12 weeks. It all depends on your goals. Where you are in relation to specific sporting events. You might be trying to peak for certain events, so you want to have high levels going into those events, and then once you're finished, you can kind of taper off of it again. Okay guys, from here we're going to be talking about beta-alanine. Now beta-alanine is something that a lot of people might not be too aware of. Typically it can be in a lot of different pre-workout supplements. Now what is the purpose of beta-alanine? Beta-alanine in fact stimulates the production of a hormone known as carnosine. Carnosine in fact acts as a lactate buffer for the body. Now a lactate buffer will actually help to prevent the excessive buildup of lactic acid within our bodies while we're exercising. By doing this is actually helping to reduce the rate of fatigue, and it can actually help to improve our performance by improving our overall endurance and ability to keep going in certain endurance based activities. Now some effects associated with the consumption of beta alanine are in relation to something called paresthesia, otherwise known as tingling sensations. Now anyone who has taken or has taken a pre-workout supplement that contains it, you may have experienced tingling somewhere on your face, could be in your fingertips, could even be down to your toes. Again, there's nothing to be worried about, it's something very common when you're starting off with the consumption of this supplement. Now in relation to supplementation, again, I'm going to say follow the instructions on the back of the packet. Typically it's going to be 3 to 5 grams per day. Generally you're going to cycle it similar to something like creatine. However, some studies have said that you may need a slightly longer period in order to get the full benefits of it. So potentially up to that 12 weeks or a little bit more, followed by 12 weeks off. Okay guys, so from here we're going to be talking about the supplement caffeine. Now I think pretty much everyone has heard of caffeine. Typically you're going to be getting it from your caffeinated drinks, so coffee, there's even some Red Bull and the likes of Monster Energy. So caffeine is a stimulant and it affects our central nervous system. So how does caffeine work? So caffeine, in fact, enters our brain. When it enters our brain, it's actually attaching itself onto something called adenosine receptors. Now, these adenosine receptors typically give us that sensation of fatigue and overall tiredness. However, when caffeine enters, it's going to reduce those effects by taking up those receptors, and it's going to give us a more alert sensation and reduce that overall sense of fatigue. However, it is important to note that the more caffeine that we take in on a regular basis, the higher the tolerance we have and the more receptors that we're going to build up over time. So that just basically means that we are, in fact, increasing our overall tolerance for caffeine. So it's going to require a larger amount of caffeine in order to get similar results. Now, some of the potential performance benefits that have been noted throughout previous studies are in relation to increased endurance, better mental focus, and reduced overall fatigue. Okay guys, so the last supplement we're going to be looking at is in relation to nitrates. So as previously noted, you can take in this supplement through the likes of powder forms and tablet forms. However, this is one of those supplements where I'd recommend you take it in through your whole foods, as it's very easy to come by. One of the typical ways you could take it in is through a beetroot or even beetroot juice itself. Now, what do nitrates actually do for our body? Nitrates cause something called vasodilation within our blood vessels. Now, vasodilation is the expansion of the blood vessels, which in fact makes it easier for our bodies to take in oxygen as well as different nutrients to help increase our overall performance. Now, by being able to take in more oxygen a little bit more rapidly and efficiently, we're actually able to increase our endurance performance overall. We can actually increase this performance as we're decreasing the cost of oxygen on our muscles as we exercise. It has also been found that by supplementing with nitrates, that we also have the potential to increase our muscular contraction potential, which can increase our overall power output. Okay guys, that was the last supplement that we're going over. So if you get the chance, I would love it if you could follow me on my Instagram and Facebook page. Both can be found at SingleMindPT. I provide online personal training, one-to-one personal training, group fitness, as well as providing nutritional plans. Thanks again. See you next time.